Wolfgang Extreme.
Say now. Why the jail, baby? This is a passing thought, man. Like, I'm just sitting around thinking, yo. Like, you know, when that slave shit popped off, yo, like, how the fuck that shit really went down? You know what I mean? Like, I'm really just sitting here in awe right now, like, thinking about this shit, like, okay, these motherfuckers know they need some niggas to come work the shit, because they can stand in the sun and shit. But how they come up with a plan way across sea to ride over the hell to Africa and know they finna trick a nigga? Well, how they was so confident like that? They just smooth like that. Them bitches, because if you think for 1 minute them crackers came over and stole us, you a dumbass nigga, man. Man, them bitches, we got their murder soon they get out of the boat. The Africans wasn't scared of no motherfucking guns. They were warriors. They were like, bitch, you gonna have to kill me, but I bet I get this damn spear up in your ass. Watch this. The motherfucker was warriors, kid. They wasn't studying all that shit. That shit was an orchestrated illustration. And when I do my observation or that evaluation, it's kind of creepy because how did the conversation go? Because first they had to have a mediator. They didn't speak their tribal language. And them Africans didn't speak English. So now they had to set it up, well, somebody got to speak for both of these people to get this agreement started. So how did they negotiate this deal? You know what I mean? It's real, real ill when I think about it because what happened? You go to the king, you're like, yo, check this out. I got a real live deal for you. Everything on this boat, man, everything you see, you can have this shit, man. This shit, top dollar shit. Valuable shit, you can't even get this shit from Africa, man. You got to come to the States, nigga, where we banging. Nigga, we smooth and cool over there, you know what I mean? Y'all dusty and shit running around, man. Y'all, look at all that gold and diamonds. I don't need that shit. You can't do that shit. You can't eat that shit. You can't do none of that shit, can you? You know what I mean? And then look at all these niggas running around everywhere, man. There's too many motherfuckers over there. Y'all need to clean up over here or something. I tell you what, we're going to do. We're going to do y'all a favor. We're going to take all these niggas that you don't need. And goddamn, you see them diamonds and gold and all of that. We're going to take all that shit to clean it up, put it on our boat, and haul it off y'all. And then we're going to get out some shit that y'all really need. You know what I mean, King? I'm going to do this for you, Kingy. Because I love you, man. I'm your partner, man. For real, go ask the Indians. They'll tell you. Shit, I'm going to give you all the salt and pepper. Lifetime supply, man. Salt and pepper that you need. You know what I mean? Shit, look at this leather. You know what I mean? You can make some real cool fucking goddamn skirt with them Zulu bitches with this shit here, boy. I'm trying to tell you now, Kingy. Hold on. Don't say no more. Only one more in my ass. Hold the fuck up. Hey, John Boy, all that gold and that diamond shit over there, and cover them niggas, get chain them niggas up, and bring that shit, start telling the fellas to haul that shit to the boat with me to clean this shit up for the king, man. Now, how about that, King? And watch this. Go give me a piece of that old goddamn buffalo oxtail or whatever the fuck y'all eating over there in that pot. Hey, now pour this shit over here. They call it a goddamn steak sauce. Yeah, get lard on that. Don't look good. No, hold on. Don't just shut up. Now taste that, man. Good, and yeah. Get all the lifetime supply of shit, man. And you run out, we'll bring some more, get some more niggas, and we'll get all this trash up, because what y'all gonna do with that gold and that diamond and shit? Man, you can't even burn this shit, man. Can't make no spit out of that shit. No bling bling, man. Y'all need shit. And that's what I be thinking, like, how the fuck did that? Man, who is sitting there negotiating for the motherfuckers, like, sitting in the middle of them, like, damn, that nigga tricking the hell out of this nigga. Damn, man, he actually finna go over there. Damn, man, he got a nigga low down the hill trying to do that. Damn, he actually buying into this shit. Damn, he finna get rid of these people. Damn, he goddamn guy. And he's going back and forth, telling the story. So, you know, man, when you think about our history, all jokes aside, man, and tell in reality, some of this shit just don't add up, man. And just a passing thought, man, I think we really need to dig a little deeper with the wisdom that we have accomplished and not that bullshit in the book. And that's to do some investigating on our own and really just see, wait a goddamn minute here. Did that really happen like them motherfuckers said? Because there ain't nobody around to tell us it did. We just reading this shit out of a book. And they trick us about everything else. I ain't going for the shit. Now they got that new age trick your nigga shit going on with the internet. They zapping our minds out. Shit, 60 seconds, nigga, you brainwashed. Come out the titty. No, you don't need that something like that no more. We got some new shit. Say, ah, nigga, spray shit in your mouth, nigga, turn to a 12-year-old boy and got down 66. And then nigga just jumped out of prison, nigga. That nigga 12 big head, nigga, he ain't wore a diaper before. Oh, hell, where they come? See, I ain't with all that old shit, man. So I guess they gonna hate me till they kill me, man. But fuck it. It's just a passing thought. Fucking bitch, I ain't no dummy.